to spend millions of dollars to buy equipment. It's not about the money. It's about the process and the sanctity of that process. And it's not just because we are sticklers for process. It is because the whole state depends on that process. Elections have consequences. If they don't bring you war, they bring you doom something. So it does matter. And it also does matter because if you lose your faith in the process, you are likely to take the law into your own hands. And that's a problem. And which is why I don't bear good news, because in the position we are in today, by virtue, the effects of the Supreme Court ruling is that today there is no rule, no law regulating elections in Ghana. I repeat, today the effect of the Supreme Court ruling is that it does not matter if you're verified or not, it does not matter if there's overvoting, it does not matter if the officials don't sign, it does not matter. Because according to the wisdom of our justices, once the vote has been declared, that is the end of it. Go to court. And unfortunately, that itself is a problem. Because going to court, you have 9 justices, 5 of them declared that there have been irregularities. In law again, you cannot declare that there have been irregularities and not have a remedy. There were only 2 issues to determine at that hearing. 1, whether there had been irregularities or not. And 2, whether the irregularities were of a significant nature. Issue number 1 was settled by everybody that there had been irregularities, including testimony from the electoral commissioner himself, or the chairman of the electoral commission himself. So issue 1 was clear. The 2nd one was issue 2, whether the irregularities were of a significant nature as to warrant some kind of remedy. And the remedies are quite a few. You can cancel the whole election, you can cancel the election for that polling station alone, or ask them to do a rerun.